Hey guys, how are you today? Hope you guys are having a great day. My name is Kelly, and I'm going to be doing a mixed media painting for our hashtag Love Summer Art big YouTube event here on YouTube. All you have to do is go to the search bar in YouTube and put in hashtag Love Summer Art, and you will see tons of artists of all types come up in the search bar and check out their videos. Leave them a thumbs up, leave them comments, and look for next month what our hashtag will be. I think this is a great thing, and I would love to know what you guys think of it. And of course, as always, please leave me a thumbs up if you like seeing my videos. And let's get going, shall we? So I'm going to do a mixed media piece. I love doing mixed media. Mixed media to me is so relaxing and so... No rules. If I mess up, I can go over it. So I'm just going to do just a mixed media piece here. This is just a piece of watercolor paper that I'm using today. And this is actually, I'm using as my stencil, but I found this on clearance in my craft store in their scrapbook paper section. They have a bunch of these, and I have quite a few of these with numbers and different shapes and all that. So that's what I'm going to use today. I am not going to add, let me see if my light helps a little bit. I'm not going to add gesso or anything to the watercolor paper, although you definitely can. But for me, I have found that adding a gesso or any type of sealant on the bottom, sometimes in mixed media, just is redundant. You're going to put up layers anyway, so it doesn't really matter to me. But if you like it, then by all means, please do it. Okay, first I'm going to do some sprays, and I'm going to use my DecoArt Media Mister, and this is in color yellow green, and these dry permanent, and I love them. Doing mixed media, this is, you know, I want things to be permanent. So, although I use a lot of water soluble too, I've done many videos with that, but I'm just going to spray. I'm not going to be fully on there because now I'm going to use, let's give it a shake, the DecoArt Media Shimmer Mister in turquoise. And you can find these on the DecoArt website. And I'm just giving little squirts here and there. All right, now I'm going to give that a second. Now, as I always, look how beautiful that is. As I always tell you guys, when I'm going to set this aside so I can show you. This is going to dry. I always take another piece of paper, and it could be scrapbook paper, it could be printer paper, it can be whatever kind of paper you want, because this is permanent. So once it's on there, it's not going to matter. And I take my stencil or whatever I used. It could be your stamp, it could be whatever you want, and I lay it on a piece of paper. And if I can't find my roly-poly, I just will use a paint bottle, but you can definitely use your paper towel. You know, you just want to pat it down so it all transfers. You don't need the pattern. You just want to get all that delicious ink off. Now, what I'm going to do, and I'm going to tell you up front here, is I'm going to add, now look at that, how gorgeous. Now that's a whole other start of a background for me when I go on to another project. And I even have a little bit more on here, but I'm not gonna waste your time watching me do another print. what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do this, and I'm gonna talk through it like I always do for my longer videos. But if you don't wanna sit and watch this long video and listen to me talk, I'm gonna put it up as a process video as well, where I just show everything that I do and speed through it so you can watch it as it comes together. So it's the best of both worlds for everybody involved. Okay, so now that I did that, I'm just going to hit it with my heat gun for a second. As I tell you guys all the time, you don't need a heat gun. Use your hair dryer. Go to the thrift store for a couple dollars and get a used hair dryer. Mine always has tons of them. Or use your own hair dryer. A heat gun is for when you emboss something because you really need that high heat. You can definitely use, you know, your coupon and get a heat gun. There's nothing wrong with it. But a lot of you have hair dryers. So why not use them, you know, double duty? Okay. So can you see how gorgeous this is? I almost want that and to frame it and put it on my wall. It's so gorgeous. Okay, so now we have that. And what I'm going to do is I want to get a color that's going to go into these white crevices, but I don't want a too dark of a color. I'm kind of looking for a light pink, maybe. Do I want pink? I don't know. Let me see. What color is this? That is glitter. I don't want glitter. I'm going to use... This is airbrush color, and I love this stuff. I have tons of color of this, and every time I go, I look for them if they're on sale or clearance. And I love using them, and you can see it's a very bright pink, and that's what I'm looking for. I'm going to take my brush. I want my brush to be dry. I don't want it... I just want it to be damp. I don't want it to be wet, because I really don't want this to be watered down that much. And I'm going to take it on my brush, and I'm going to add... Now, you can add more. I have a thing where I either add it onto my paper, or... But since I didn't gesso it, I really don't want to do that, because what will happen... And you can. It's not going to hurt anything. Come on, baby, squirt out. Hands are not working for me today. But you definitely can put it on your paper. It just will... If you don't gesso it, it'll get like a little, I'll show you, because it's not the end of the world. I just added in as texture. I know I have, yeah, orange over there and red. Let me grab them. I really like the bright pink though. Let's see. I have this color and this color. I have orange and I have red. Is that red? Yeah. I'm going to shake it up. Now watch. What happens is it's going to soak into the paper a bit. All right, and I'm just kind of going like this. Look at those beautiful colors. It's so pretty. So sometimes you'll get like a little dot where you'll see that you put that in on the paper because it soaks in. It doesn't matter. Now, I covered it more than I wanted to, but I'm not going to worry about it too much. I'm not too worried. Just gonna give it a wipe to dry it. Because I know that when I go over this again, now watch, this is what happens. If you do something like this, it's not the end of the world. Put your stencil back on and you can try to add it, you know, kind of where you had it if you can. If not, it's not a big deal. It's not a big deal. It just adds more texture and deliciousness. And let's go again with the green. Shake it up. I just love it. I just love it. And I'm using the same colors. No worries. And I'm going to lift it up again and still have some brighter colors coming through. So now I'm gonna dry it. Again, you don't have to add all this. This happens, you know, a lot of people will say to me, oh my gosh, why did you cover that? But I do it because I love mixed media and I love all that texture that it gives. And I do that quite a bit. Now this mister is, the blue spray has a little bit of mica in it, so it has a great shine to it. Okay, there we go. Now you can definitely add by using some molding paste. I call it molding paste. It's called modeling paste. Depends on what brand you use. But you definitely at this point can add some of that in for texture. But I'm not going to today. I'm just going to kind of play where we're at. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a brush. And I'm going to take... Ceram Coat, it's Santa's Flesh. It's one of my favorite colors. I'm going to put it down here. And I'm going to just give me a little bit of a face. I'm going to go around. These are my new favorite things to do. I love doing faces and different types of, I don't know, hair and just looks. And because it's mixed media, I want that to come through. I want that underneath to come through. I'm not worried about it. If the color mixes, I just don't care. I'm just going to add a little dip down here for the chin. And then take the rest. And I'm just going to kind of go down for the neck. All right, happy, happy, happy with that. And I'll just scrape up the rest and just go over it. A lot of it will be covered by hair. Okay, that's what I'm going to do with that. And I'm going to dry it because I don't necessarily want everything to go through and smush, is like what I like to call it. Blend together, smush, whatever. I love doing paintings with sayings on them, like with inspirational sayings. I don't necessarily know what I'm going to do with this one yet, but I do love it. So what I'm going to do is, like, you can see I have a little bit of my skin color here, and I'm just going to add a little bit of transparent yellow. Is that ochre? I can't read. Yellow iron. I'm just going to add a drop or two in that, and I'm going to take my small brush. Make sure it's dry. You don't want it to be wet. And I'm going to mix in here. And it'll reactivate a little bit of that. But I want it to be light enough because this is going to be my drawing utensil. Okay. And I'm going to go in and add where I want my eyes to be. Let's see the bottom. And again, I like to take something that is straight and I add it on here so I can kind of judge where the eye is going to go over here and that it's straight as well and they're even. Sometimes with my hands, as most of you know, I have RA, I have fibro, and a lot of times with my hands, and the way I have to turn things for my hands to function correctly, I always am like this. I can get the eyes off once in a while, and it's not a big deal. I rock with it, and I roll with it, and I do it. But that is, I tell you guys all the time, whether you have issues with your hands or not, it's the best way to do it. Now I'm going to go, and I'm going to go in, and I'm going to make my eyelid like this on both of them. I'm not going to worry too much if they're the same size or not. Just going with it. And another thing I want to tell you guys, which I tell you all the time, if you need to erase some of the paint off, wet your brush. You want to leave it fairly wet. And you just kind of go in and you run over the part that you want to erase. Okay. Dry off your brush again. And go in and lift. And you're going to see it's going to lift off that layer that you just wet. See? And it works just like that. Now I'm going to move in a bit just while I'm working on the face. Now you can see this one's shorter, but I'll tell you a trick. What I like to do is if this happens and you're just painting, I just want to have fun. I'm not worrying about it. But if this happens and you look at it and you're like, oh my aunt, you just make the hair go right there. So it kind of cuts that eye a bit and it just makes like the hairs over it. And we'll get to that in a second. So I'm going to take a little bit more of this and I'm going to go in and I'm going to kind of make this neck area. I can see that's a little low. I love making mistakes and showing you guys how easy it is to clean them up when you're done. You can even take your paper towel and just suck up all that water that you just did. And you're good to go. And that'll be our area there. And then I like to roll it to get it to a nice point. And get some of that paint on there. And I'll go in for my nose. Now your nose, essentially, you know, you kind of want it. Just going to set my pencil here. You know, you kind of want it in the middle. So I'm just going to eye it. Kind of put it there. It's my little nose. Same thing. I'll just do my nose. And then go ahead and do my mouth. Now, a great way to do your mouth, I'm going to show you. Let me blow this dry so it doesn't run. I'm going to touch it. Okay, take your, you could do two circles. Now, you can draw them with your, you know, your hand yourself, or you can definitely use circles on a circle template, which you guys know I love these. I've done many giveaways with these. And what you'll do is you will paint the circles next to each other. But if you don't have that, it's okay. Just paint them. You can sketch them out with a pencil very lightly like this. Very lightly. See how we do that? Now you can see, now look, this is a big mistake I made. I do not have that directly under, so I'm going to erase that. And because we have that paint down, that's going to help us erase it a lot easier. So I need to know, I need to draw my line down the center the best that you can, and then put your circles on each side. Okay? And then add an oval underneath. Like that. Now, I like to, you don't have to, but I like to erase it now till it's very light so I can still see it, but it's not all that lead on there. But that's up to you. Take your brush again and then just paint in, because this is just the shadowing I'm putting in right now. So I know where it's at. And then I'll decide to color and do that, but I'm not going to worry about that right now. Just attach it. Like that. And you have lips. Very simple. Practice it a couple times and I bet you have it under no problem. No problemo. Alright, and then that'll just sit there till I decide what color. So now I have that in. I'm going to do the eyes. I'm not going to do so much of an oval. I'm going to kind of just put a little bit underneath here of a curve. Not too much, but enough. Okay, and you can see that it's a little, you know, just going to kind of over this. Like that. And I'm going to take this very little bit of paint I have on here and add just a little bit of the nose. Very simple, not a big deal. Now what I'm going to do, and you could do this if you want, I'm going to take my flush color again, and I'm just going to take it out of the cap because, you know, I paint out of the cap all the time. I'm just going to put a little bit, and what I'm going to do is go in and just kind of blend some of that thickness out. And on the bottom, just so it's a little straightened, you know, a little more crisp looking. It's almost like erasing it. And the same thing over here. You don't have to do this, but that's how I'm doing it today. Because I will go in later and fix them with a darker when I just outline them. Okay, and then I'm gonna kind of narrow that in a little bit. Perfect. That is what I want. I'm going to leave that dry. And now I'm going to work on her hair. So I'm going to take my brush and dry it off. I don't want it a lot. And I want, what color do I want? I don't know. I love doing these. I can't stand it. Geez, what color do I want to do? Orange. Let's do. You know what? I'm going to go for black because I like black. And I'm just going to put some black there. And it's Delta Ceramic Coat. And it is in the color black. I'm going to take my brush. And I'm going to dip it in. And I know I'm going to. I think I might want to do curly. So what I'm going to start out as, and this is not how it's going to be curly, but it just gives me, I just want some texture in there, and I don't want it too big. And you'll see what I mean in a second. This is just, it's all going to be covered. All right, so I want her to have, I always do this, and I guess it's because that's how I wear my hair. With the bang. And when you get those dry marks, like I tell you guys, it's because it's dry. The brush is dry. Now go in and kind of color, paint all that in, but leave those waves on the outside if you can for a little bit of texture, but you don't have to. You can definitely do straight. Definitely can do straight hair. You do whatever kind of hair you want. And if you want, you can leave some of that background showing through. You don't have to necessarily do it the way I'm doing it. But here goes the eye. You know, so I'm just going to take it on that face right there. Take it on the face. I'm going to put the hair on the face. Oh, Kelly, Kelly, Kelly. And you can go over it a little bit so it's covered, more covered, which I'm going to do right here. Now look, I'm holding my pencil. I mean, my paintbrush like a pencil. So, you know, you definitely want to do that when you're doing more of a detailed kind of thing. Not that the hair is detailed, but I want to have a little bit more control where sometimes I just hold it on the outside and I just go for it. And I'll bring this down here. I might just take it all the way to the bottom. Go on the neck a little bit. You can definitely do that. Kind of do that. They don't have to match on each side. It totally depends on what you are trying to do, but I'm loving it. I love that. I might have to put something in her hair, which I think I might know what to do, what I'm going to do. But that's all I'm going to do with that. I'm just doing a face, very, very simple on that. Now, I want to work on the eyes. So what I'm going to do while the hair dries is I'm going to decide what color eyes I'm going to use. Now, normally I do green because of my daughter and she has green eyes. The other painting I did was blue, so I am going to use green. And this is blue-green light, because my daughter has hazel eyes, but I always do green. Don't know why. Make sure your brush is completely dry so you don't get any dripping. And you can definitely draw your eyeball before you want, you know, with a pencil or whatever. But I'm just going in for it. This is called Have Fun and Paint. Paint in your circle, and you definitely can use your template to get a perfect circle. But I'm just having fun and painting. She looks crazy, doesn't she? She's like, "Oh, I'm scared. Scared." Okay. While that's wet, I'm going to add a little bit of, what color? A little bit of the transparent brown in there. Oh, God, I got to turn my thing off. Just so you see a little bit of it, because my daughter has all kinds of specks and different colors in her eyes, so. Gonna do that just a little bit. You can add gold or whatever. Now I'm gonna rinse out my brush and I'm gonna go back into this brown. Now you can use an extender or, you know, a drying time extender for your paint, definitely, due to you know, so as you're sitting here it doesn't dry. I just add a little bit of water, but you can definitely do either way. And I'm gonna go in for the eyelids, and what I'm going to do is go over and a little bit of black to that. So it's not jet black, but it's a nice shadow. And then trace. You have more control when you hold down low there. I'm going to do that, and I'm going to take a little bit more. All right, I'm going to turn that off. I like it. So I'm going to take just the same color and kind of go down. I have those shadows in for her nose. Going to leave the lips alone. So I'm going to color them. I'm going to paint them and go in here. Give a little bit of that. So she has that shadow. And there, and I'm going to go in and draw in some brows that I can go over later. But you know what I want to do first before I do that? I'm going to rinse my brush off. Okay. I'm going to take my color again, my Santa's flush, right? And what I'm going to do, because I'm not digging, I'm just going to go in and shrink it down. See how I'm just playing with it a little bit to edit that a little bit because it was a little bit too much, right? You don't know until you go back in and you really look at it. Sometimes I take pictures of things that I'm going to, and then I'm going to clean up. Well, I'll do those later. You don't know until I look in the monitor or I take pictures as I'm going through paintings, especially ones I'm going to sell. And I just, you know, kind of see what I have going on. And it helps, you know, because then you can see a little bit better the, you know, not everybody, not many people at all, I would assume, have equal features, you know, like on this side it's this and this side it's that. But, you know, so we're not all symmetrical. Some people have a bigger eye, some people have a bigger boob, some people have, you know, it goes all over the place. So, what I'm going to do now is pick the color I want for the lips. And I think I'm going to go for bright pink. Let's see how this airbrush works for that, because it's very liquidy. But I like the vibrancy with the black hair. But I think it's a little bit too liquidy. Let's face it. So I'm going to let that dry, and then I'll go in with a different, thicker color, because that's going to just drive me nuts. So I'm just going to add the pink so it doesn't go to waste. I have some white areas. And my pencil. Just do that. Okay. Take a little bit of my green here. Just a little bit. And just there we go. A little bit better there. And I'm going to take my pink. It's a regular acrylic pink. I'll try to mix it in there with that pink. A little bit better. I can always edit that, you know, fix that. Let's do the pupils. So, excuse me, I'm going to use the back of my brush. And just so I can lay in where I want it. And then I can kind of paint with that. So I lay it in there. And I need some eyebrows. And a lot of the eyebrow is not going to show because of the hair. So we're just going to kind of put it in like that. On this side, it'll show a little bit more. You can even go in and draw it with my paintbrush. I'm just adding in like that. This needs to be a little thicker. Like that. And I'm going to draw. Now, I love using, I don't think that's going to be dry yet. All right, I'll leave the lips alone for a second. I'm going to go into the hair I want to add a bird. I just want to add a bird. I don't know why. I'll have it sitting over here. How should I have it sitting? Half on and half off. And I think I'm going to use some crackle paste. I don't know if I'm going to get the full crackle. We will see. But I'm going to hold it down. I'm just using the stencil. And I'm going to give it a swipe through. And the main reason I'm doing this is because I want whatever color I paint it to come through. I don't want it to be muted because I'm painting it on black. If that makes sense. But I'm not making it too thick, so I don't know if the crackle's going to work. I guess we'll see. But you can paint it thick. You can paint it whatever you want it. It's okay if it's on our hair, too. It doesn't matter. We're just playing. All right. I don't know. I love birds. So I'm going to take some of this. No, I got to clean my brush off first. Let me clean my brush. Dry my brush. I need white. White, white, white. Do I have white here? No. I'll just use a little bit of this while the bird dries. And I'm going to go in and do a little bit of white. Too much water on here. So it kind of, you know, they kind of stick out a little bit. They kind of not stick out, but okay. I'm gonna let that dry for a minute so I can go back and shape the eyeball. Now, I'm only doing a mixed media face here, a very folk arty kind of girl, right? So if you were doing more realistic, you know, our eyes aren't that white. We have pink, we have, you know, darker colors, the shadows. So, you know, remember that when you're doing it. If you want to do more realistic, I just like having a blast and just painting faces. So it doesn't, you know, it doesn't affect me. Sometimes, you know, you want it to be a little more realistic or a little more whimsy. It's up to you. I'm just going to dry this and dry the bird so I can paint it. I'm going to grab gold and I'm going to paint in the bird some gold. This is just metallic gold. I'm going to go in and I'm just going to paint it. I just want it to be gold. No rhyme or reason. I'm probably going to do gold and green. Little head gold. I'm very cute, but I'm going to do the head. I'm going to add a little bit of orange on his head to make it pop a little bit more, because as you can see, it kind of blends in, you know. And that's going to make it blend in as well. But I am going to trace it, but I just want a little bit of those colors through there. And then I'm going to add orange as the beak. Orange is the new beak. And then I'll outline it. And his little feetsies. And what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to like scrape the back of my paintbrush. That might be a little too wet for me to do it there, but I'm just going to give some scrapes for the look of feathers. And then I'm going to take some grain. Kind of. I'll just add it in there. Pull it through. By no means am I a bird. I love birds. I can sit and watch birds forever, but I'm not a, you know, I don't really paint realistic-y birds, I guess is the, so it's just, I want her to have a little bit in there, and then I'll cover that with green, but I'm going to go in while I have this green out. I'm just going to touch up the eyes a bit. And these fluid acrylics will paint over anything. They are fantastic. And you know what? I'm going to do some leaves. Oh, my nose. Like that. Kel. I'm gonna get these pupils a little smaller and go in with my circle thing. I'm having a hard time today with my hands to get the control I want, so I might have to use my circle template. But I'm not gonna worry about it too much. I'll handle it. And some brown for the branch, because this is just crazy. Pull these through. Pull it through on the head. Okay. Okay. And need a little bit more pink. To go through. Then I'll line those. want my bird to have a dot as an eye, so. He has a little friendly eye. I do have to do the beak a little bit better. I don't know if orange is going to work. I want to do the, yeah, pupil a little bit better. I'll go in and like fix them up when it's time. I can see I squished a little bit of the paint there, but I really don't care. And I want to do, what else do I want to do? Oh, there's so much. I want to highlight. Let's do some of that. This is all drying. Put some black in there. I need some. A bit of white. I just want a little bit of highlights, but that's going to be too black. You know what I'll use? I know what I'll use. Because I want to do my hair. I used to do it. I'm going to have it match the lipsticks, I think. I mean, no, I'll do red. I'll do red. Just some highlights. Because I just want to kind of follow the flow of the hair. Nothing fancy. I'm not going all fancy schmancy. Just going to add some highlights. And do it this way. If you think they're too dark, just kind of pat them down, you know, like kind of run over them again, because it'll blend it in a little bit better. I don't know how well you can see them. I just want them to kind of show through. And what I'm going to do is paint bangs without dry paint on it. So she has a strip. Down here. You can see how well. I mean, hair doesn't look so prim and proper when you're standing. It just kind of has its highlights and its movement. So I'm not going to beat myself up because I'm having a bad health day today. I just want to play. Yeah. That's what I want. And I want it on this side too. Because this is what I'm going to do to my hair again. I had it like this for so long. And I think I'm going to go back and do it again. So I need to do something because them grays are saying hello a little too often. That color hair. Now you know what I'm thinking about. I'm thinking about just doing the whole head that. I think that's what I'm gonna do. This is why things talk to you. I just like it a lot better. I don't know. So that's what I'm gonna do. And now that black will act like a gesso underneath for me. So see how I changed it? It's okay. A lot of you ask me that a lot. A lot of you ask me that a lot. Because I change things all the time because things talk to me. Things will say, like, nope, nope, nope. I start out one way and I go another. And there's nothing wrong with that. That's what's following your muse is. That's your muse saying to you, look, girl or boy, do it. And I don't care some of the black shows through on the bottom. It just adds depth. It's called having fun. Just add shadows and dimension, and that's just how I rock it. I love it. Now I just got to get these lips drawn if it ever dries. Now normally I would use my pen, and I'm going to do my pen up here and show you what I mean. As soon as I get these lips dry, these lips are giving me more problems of drying. I just don't understand why not. Like, they keep drawing, like, I know the... Oh, don't touch that after you blow it like that, because it's very hot. Ah! Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you very quickly. I take my circle thing from my eyes. Now, I have problems today with my hands. They're really bad, but it's not going to stop me because I'm unstoppable. All I'm going to do is lay this one down. You can see I use this one an awful lot. And I'm going to take my small brush... Right? I'm going to dry it, make sure it's dry and it's not going to run off. I'm going to take my black paint and I'm going in, or you could use your pencil, and I'm just going in like that, just so it makes it a little bit more, make sure you wipe the back of this off when you go sit it, just so it makes it a little bit more oval. You know what I'm saying? More circular. Okay. And then go ahead and do the same over here. And it just gives you a little bit more, see how much better it looks. And you can even do that with the bigger circles for the green. I'm not going to do that right now. But what I am going to do is I'm going to take, I love my Energel pen. You can use your, whatever pen you have, your Sakura, your, what's my white pen I use? My Jelly Roll, your Faber-Castell Pitt pen. I use it all. I'm using this right now. I'm going to go in and I'm probably going to have white paint on me, but I'm going to go in and just kind of outline these eyes a bit. And this works perfect. And it just makes them stand out more. And that's kind of what I want. I want that little bit of brown on the bottom. I'm going to even try to do eyelashes, which you guys know I'm not good at. I'm not good at even holding a pen sometimes. Today's not a good day, but I'm going for it. Because why not? Just makes them stand out more. And then even when we put the little highlight in. But boy, the eyelashes and all will be good. Okay, so now I'm going to go over the nose area a little bit. And it's just to bring... it out more. So she has a little nose. And I'm going to do the eyeballs themselves. Perfection not wanted nor needed. And then I'm going to go for the lips. And you'll see, just brings them out and makes them a little bit more. You can see how it's patchy. I don't know what the heck went on with that, but I'm not going to worry about it. Now, I want to put some eyelashes down here. I don't do eyelashes very well. But I want her to have like spidery eyelashes. And then that's all. Nothing too fancy. I want her to have yeah, see, I'm not good at eyelashes, so this is just me experimenting and playing, but you don't have to do that part. And if you do good eyelashes, good for you. What I would probably do is sit here and make them very thick, like spiders on her, because I like it to be creepy, you know, a little goth-like, but I'm not going to do that today. I might do it later with this. Who knows? But, I mean, that's, you know, I'm a nature freak. I love it. What I'd like to do, I'm not going to do it now, but I'd like to put some, like a big tree behind her or something. That's just kind of how I am. That's what summer, I love summer and I love trees. But what I'm going to do now is just take a little bit of white, and you can use your jelly roll or your white paint, whatever, just to give her a little bit of glare. It always goes on the same side. Don't forget that. Make sure you wipe off your pen so it doesn't have that acrylic on it. And then I kind of go in here and just kind of add some highlight. Just so it gives a little bit of shine, a little bit of, you know, a little bit of something. And then I would just continue playing with her, but for 58 minutes, I'm done, and I'm done talking because I've been talking your ear off. But that's how I do it. Like I said, the eyelashes, I don't know. I'm not really thrilled with them, to be honest. I don't like to do eyelashes. So you know what I might do? Really quick, just to show you. You can turn it off now. She's pretty much done. But what I'm going to do, since I don't like the eyelashes, is I'm going to take a small brush. I'm going to take my skin color again. And I'm going in. And you can see it's not dry yet. So it's going to smear a little bit. But I don't care. Because it's just going to give me that cool smoky look. And I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that. Rinse your brush. Dry your brush. Going in. We're going to do this. I can cover the little black there I messed up. Scrub this in. And I can take it up here a little bit. And I'll take it up here. But what I'm going to do is keep the eyelashes on top. And I can just go over and do another I like the smoky look. Hear that. I like it. always turn a negative into a positive, I say. I like it. I'm going to take a little bit of this and just kind of wipe this out a little bit. Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm going to just put a little bit there. A little bit there. I love it. Not happy with that, but that's okay. That'll just give her a little shine on her nose, which is, we all have that. Kind of blend it a little bit. I love it. 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 Now, once that dries, I'll put on the eyelashes. And that'll be it. But that's just fun playing. Nothing major. I'm going to add this, like I said, in a speed up version too. Sped up version. For those who don't want to sit and listen to me talk and do this, I think I'm going to start doing that from now on. Sometimes, because I know a lot of you love to sit and watch. And a lot of you just want to see it in fast version. So, whatever you guys want, you guys can pick. And that's my little girl for today, for the summer. Like I said, turn a negative into a positive. I did that. I didn't like her eyelashes, but I dig this because I like to go, you know, I would probably do her very goth and do all that, and I might do another one like that. Who knows? But for now, this is it. So don't forget to check out hashtag love summer art in the YouTube search. Love all you guys. As always, be kind to each other. You never know what battle somebody else is fighting. Have a blast on today and for the next 3 days with that. And just work on your art, whatever kind it is, if whether you're a beginner or, you know, what is it, a beginner or non-beginner, you just do it. You just do it and have fun. Try new mediums. Check out everybody. That's all I got to say. I love you guys. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.